back, starting the stream up again. Looks like the stream is just about ready to start. All right, I'm live on YouTube, and Twitch should be starting up again in just a second. So here I am continuing the punk rock opera cover, which is My Son the Rocker. And here you can see what I'm working on. This will be him squeezed into a square for a CD cover. And here you can see what has gone before. This was his previous album cover and the one before that that I did. So back on the new one. He wants this position, but can't quite fit that position in, but I'm getting as close as I can to keeping it in the square. So that is the goal. Action, but squeezed into a square. But with the generally the same jumping kind of position. So, I think I'm going to work on his hand right now. Thank you for sticking with me, folks. I presume that Twitch is working again. I don't have a Twitch window open. I have just the chat. Let's see, Michael gave me the hand position that he absolutely wanted, which was this. That's the hand position he's looking for. Guess I'm kind of getting there. Close enough. This is more crosshatch detail than I can get away with in an editorial cartoon. Editorial cartoons have to be drawn with a little bit of lowest common denominator in mind. Lowest common denominator being how small is it going to be printed? Oops. Kim G writes, so forgive me if you've already mentioned this. How much of your skill is God-given and how much from formal instruction? Well, there's some formal instruction there, but, you know, most of what happens to get you to draw well is practice. And when I was little, I collected comics and drew my own comic books in the superheroes. And I tell ya, that is the same history that most cartoonists have, is the comic books and superheroes and sitting on the floor drawing your superheroes. And kids these days play video games instead of sitting and drawing their comics. And I notice when I look at the web comics and stuff of all the stick figures and the seeming lack of value placed on drawings, traditional drawing skills, that I think that's a bit disappointing. That's another old man thing to say, huh? Sometimes I say things like that, and my daughter says, "Stop saying that! It's an old man thing to say." So, if you would, folks, please subscribe to me on Twitch. I would much appreciate that, because I'm just trying to build an audience here, and that seems to be kind of slow going. I find that the people who visit our Cagle.com site are interested in looking quickly through a bunch of cartoons. Not particularly interested in sitting with me all afternoon while I draw the punk rock CD cover. But you know, a heck of a lot of the cartoonist life is sitting all day long drawing on stuff. That takes longer than people think it should be taking you to do such a thing. Oh, now that I've drawn that hand, I can tear it off and see the guitar underneath. Hand came out a little bigger than I thought it would. Bring up the guitar again. Alright, that's what I'm looking at. The guitar has to be black. So excuse me for sitting silently here. But you guys are silent. So chat with me, folks. You got nothing to say? I thought when I was doing my editorial cartoons on the live stream on Twitch that I would have lots of comments about politics. People would be arguing politics. And interestingly, that didn't happen. People have how-to kind of questions. Perhaps you folks think arguing about politics on Twitch is rude. But I tell ya, I think part of it is that just it's not a topic of conversation that you hear a lot among the age demographic of people that are on Twitch. Just doesn't come up. Heinz 235 writes, "Hey Daryl, has there been any big events that have inspired your work? A lot has been going on this year." I'm more inspired when there's something that makes me angry. And I guess there's plenty to make you angry these days, huh? I have a couple of, I usually have a list of editorial cartoon ideas that are waiting in line for the next one to be drawn, and if I was drawing for a daily newspaper again, and I had to put out one cartoon a day, you know, I'd be drawing more of those cartoons from the list that don't quite make it up to the number one spot and get drawn. So the two that are waiting to be drawn right now is I want to draw, and I may not draw that because a better idea will come along, but I was thinking of drawing Donald Trump standing next to Ted Cruz, pointing at Ted Cruz's crotch. Ted Cruz is naked, and over his crotch he has the Canadian maple leaf, and Donald Cruz pointing at his maple leaf junk. That strikes me as kind of funny. You know, the cartoonists have a kind of a professional obligation. If you've got a gag about a politician that you can draw either naked or cross-dressing or as a dog peeing on something, kind of have an obligation to do that one. I do look for the excuses to draw the politicians naked. And I'm kind of surprised that I haven't seen anybody else doing maple leaf. Oh boy. My chroma key, you know what happens with that is it gets later in the day and the lighting through the windows changes. So let me correct the chroma key and then we will get back to my favorite subject matter to draw. Boy, chroma key is just getting rowdy. Okay, I think, oh boy. Give me a minute. I can't have this happening. But stream is back online. We should be good again. If you stuck with me, I appreciate it. My apologies for the technical difficulties. Raspy CS, nice beard. Oh, thank you. Looks like you guys popped back. Nice to see you here again. Sorry about the interruption as I tried to fix my squirrely chroma key changing as the sunlight changes in the room. OBS decided it was time to quit. Stinking program crashed three times. The OBS for PCs is much better than the OBS for Mac. I think the whole idea of doing this streaming on a Mac is a afterthought. Everything is designed for gamers with PCs. And not only are the functions on the Mac version of OBS lousy compared to the PC version, but program is not entirely stable. So, once in a while it decides it just wants to quit. So, my apologies. It does better when you get it working the first time and then you don't touch it. But, you know. The light changes through the day, and the chroma key decides to become squirrely. Gotta deal with it. Problem is that streams keep buffering, I believe, writes D3 and 3. Nice to see you here, D3 and 3. Actually, I think the stream is working pretty well today. I'm not getting dropped frames, and it looks pretty clean. I think the problem is not the stream. I think the problem is the darn OBS program is just not as stable on a Mac as it should be. Sometimes it's gets into a little mood where it's constructive and you don't futz with it, then it stays. I think it's back in a little bit of a stable position now until I try to adjust the chroma key again. So if you would, folks, D3 and 3, please subscribe to me. I appreciate it. I'm not having as much audience as I would like to have here on Twitch. They don't want to pay attention to you or make you a partner until you've got a good number of subscribers. And I kind of think that the people who are editorial cartoon fans are not much into the subscribing to live feeds on Twitch. Oh, thank you, D3N3. I appreciate your support. Yeah, and if anybody is enough of a fan to ask a friend to look in and subscribe, that would be very nice too. I would appreciate that. Yeah, drawing this hair like this is something that's taking that part of my brain that I need to mumble. He needed a bunch more hair. The drawing is kind of turning out to be about the hair. Looks like I lost some people when I had that OBS failure. I'm not sure I'm happy with his nose and his snuff box. Yeah, right. OBS crashed on you? Yes, crashed about 4 times in a row there. What happened, Theo, was the sun is setting, and so the room got darker. I needed to adjust the chroma key and that was enough to make the OBS crash. D3N3 D3 and 3. How long have you been streaming since, date-wise? I'm still pretty new to this. I haven't been consistent about streaming, so I did a couple of tests, and it's only recently that I've been trying to stream all the drawings. So I'd say about a couple of weeks of streaming all the drawings. But, a bit more practice before that, trying to get things to work, because it's kind of challenging. Not only is it technically challenging, particularly on a Mac, but, creatively challenging to try to sit here and chat all the time while I'm drawing. Hey Theo, do you get a measure of how many people are watching on Twitch? I only get a number on YouTube. Most people are so silent. Kind of nice to know how many people are there watching silently. Eight people watching on Twitch. Oh, all right. It's a silent eight. Interesting shine that we get here from the lights up there. It's one of the things I like about pencil is there's this textural quality that I see here and that you're getting with the light, at least, that is nice. Clearly, I get more people looking at these after they're saved as videos than I do people that are willing to sit with the live stream, which is kind of disappointing because I would like to interact with people. So over here on the right side, I have a piece of fine grain sandpaper that I use to give my pencil the chisel point that I like. case you're wondering what I'm reaching over to the right to do every so often. Marilyn Harmon writes, it takes a while for people to find you. Give it a month or so. Okay. Thank you, Marilyn. Marilyn, do please subscribe to me, because I would like to be a Twitch partner, and they are reluctant to do so for somebody who does not have enough followers. You would think that they would want to take special care to try to cultivate new kinds of artists like editorial cartoonists to come in with all the kids that are drawing manga. But I think they only look at the numbers. Marilyn followed me. Oh, thank you. Theo, we need a cute little animation for when somebody follows. This guy's got a mane. He's starting to be a little bit like, oh, shoot, I'm forgetting. Who's the lion guy who was the Kraven the Hunter? Old Marvel guy with the big bunch of hair. So thank you for following me, Marilyn. Oh, thank you, Theo. I would like to have a cute Twitch alert. I noticed the dancing taco. I like the dancing taco. As I draw this, I'm trying to think of which way the shirt goes and which way the lighting is going. I need a drop shadow behind the guitar. I spent much of my career as an advertising illustrator doing illustration jobs like this. Actually, most of the jobs I did were character jobs and toy design. Not many CD covers. wrong. I've got to get the guitar just right. Brian and Deanna Anderson. Twitch will not allow me to log in. Sorry, I'm silent. I like watching because I cannot draw worth beans. Thank you for watching, Brian. Oh, you can subscribe to me on YouTube as well. That would be nice. We have 6 people watching on YouTube. See, my son sent me a photograph of just what it should look like, where the plug sticks into the guitar. If I can find that, to find the stuff on my phone. Okay, here it is. Bigger. Alright, well, that's as big as I'm gonna get. That's how the plug goes in. So, straight across there. Little metallic plug. Alrighty. Feral Jew Boy. Hey, Daryl, how are you? I hope you're well. Checking in here from London, England. Nice to see you here, Feral. Feral, be sure to subscribe to me, because I am hurting for subscribers. And I need for Twitch to take me seriously. I think Twitch only takes subscribers seriously. Just poke the picture firmly once, Michael says. Look at this, Michael. Poke the picture firmly once. I have trouble with images in chat. Much better if you email them to me. Anyway, I can't make it big. And likewise, if I email it to myself, it takes about 5 hours to get to me. So, images in chat are not good. Once quickly, you say. Okay, once quickly. Ah! Ha ha ha! Alright. Flip, flip, flip! Alright, that's weird. Oh, it's got a... I didn't realize it had this little screw. Yeah, that's why I needed to blow it up. Okay. Thank you, Michael. For those of you that are new and just joining me now, I'm doing a punk rock CD cover. I see you there, Feral Jew Boy. And this is a rock album cover for a punk rock album cover for my son. And this is previous punk rock album cover I did for him. And another previous one with the jazzy B So this one is more of a portrait of Michael. Well, sorry, Farrell, but it looks to me like the stream is working and the problem is all on your end. My test windows are looking good. I've got a Twitch and a YouTube test open. Do I charge my son for this, or does he get mate's rates? Nah, I'm not charging him for this. This is one of the perks of having a cartoonist dad. Marilyn Harmon says it's buffering there a lot as well. Well, what can I tell you, folks? But the problem's on your end. I've got no buffering in my test windows. So my apologies. I hate to suggest it, but it seems that you might get a better stream if you reduce it to 720 instead of full HD. I hate to suggest that because you're looking at a pencil drawing, you know? You want to see the little details. I've got this all set up so that I think you're seeing pretty darn good focus on the little details. But what can I say? Part of this was that my son sent me this image, which is what he wanted the album to look like, and he wants me to match all the details of the clothes and the position. Kid Scoop News writes, "Hi Daryl, which politician is your favorite to draw, current and or from the past?" Well, I know that this is not going to be a popular answer, but I think the best cartoon character politician of them all is Hillary, because Hillary has so much wonderful history. What you really want from a political cartoon character is for people to have background knowledge, so that it's kind of like Charlie Brown and Lucy in the football. You know that Lucy's gonna pull the football away, and when she does, that's rewarding, because there's something rewarding about a character who does what you expect the character to do. And in the case of Hillary, she's got so much background that so many people are familiar with. It's like I've got a Peanuts character that everybody knows. And I can just have her do what you know she would do and think what you know she would think. I remember she was doing a book tour at the same time as Bill Clinton. And I think they did a book signing together. And so I drew a cartoon about that, which was a wordless cartoon. I had Bill Clinton, he's opening up his book, and it's got the the Playboy centerfold and it drops out, and then Hillary gives him a dirty look and whacks him over the head with her book. And that's the kind of thing that you can only do with characters that are so well known and so well defined that I didn't draw my tuning knobs, and there they are right there in the photo. All right, Michael, you are absolutely right. I need to go in and fix that and add the tuning knobs. They go in his hair. They are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm going to have to do it that way. Make space for the tuning knobs. Brian and Deanna Anderson, right? They need to get a faster connection from their service provider. Yeah, this really is pretty heavy computer use to watch a live stream like this. Not unlike watching your Netflix. But, like I say, you know, turn down the resolution and it'll work fine. Okay, tuning knobs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. No, you're not causing trouble, Michael. I needed to do the tuning knobs. I just wasn't thinking of it. I think that's okay. You are the art director, Michael. So do not hesitate to comment. For those of you not quite following, this is my son's rock, punk rock album cover that I'm working on, and my son is among those watching on Twitch. Looking good. You happy, Michael? Is it looking good? I'm coming up on 3 hours on this so far. I would have guessed that this is more like a 4 or 5 hour job. I think, you know, a big reason that bands don't have nice art covers like this is that they don't have a cartoonist dad. And if you're going to hire somebody for this, hire me to do this, I would want a nice paycheck that I think is out of range for most bands. Yeah, I'm not, all I'm getting on Twitch is just the chat box. I don't have a switch window open because I don't want to have too many stresses and strains on my own connection here while I'm trying to get OBS to broadcast. So I don't see anything like how many people are watching on Twitch. Well, it looks to me like I've got such a big blank space happening on his upper arm that I'm going to need to give this Air Force logo more emphasis than I think it actually has on your actual arm, Michael. To deal with the space. Hey, you folks on YouTube that are not saying anything, really would appreciate your subscribing to my feed, liking my feed, or if you are really generous, go over and watch me on twitch.tv/DarylCagle or on the front page of Cagle.com where we have a pop-up window. And subscribe to me, follow me on Twitch. I would appreciate that because that's the where I'm trying to get the live feed to work. And for Twitch to give me a partnership, they want me to have 100 subscribers, which seems like quite a hurdle to come up with at the beginning when I don't have an audience. There's a bit of a catch-22 is for them to feature you and hope you get audience, you have to already have audience. Haven't quite figured that one out. Michael, get your friends to subscribe to me while I'm here drawing your album cover. Hey, Michael, post your links to your music again. It's been a while. Those folks probably are gone, and the new people haven't seen it. Give a bit more insight into what the heck I'm drawing. Okay, big Air Force symbol on arm. How to handle that? Ah, very good, Michael. Thank you. excuse me just a second. Kid Scoop News writes, how long do you typically spend working on a single political cartoon? Well, you know, you can't just count the time that I'm sitting there drawing, because I spend all this time reading a couple newspapers a day and following all the stuff and figuring things out and then doing all the business stuff with it. The actual drawing time is the least of it. But you can watch my previous feeds and you can see how long it takes. I'd say it takes anywhere from 2.5 hours at the shortest, including coloring time, to about 8 hours per cartoon, including coloring time. Oh, I see. There's 6 people watching on Twitch. And 5 people watching on YouTube. Probably a couple less than that, since I have to count myself. One thing about the live streaming is that I don't watch as many talking heads on TV as I used to. Since I'm sitting in a quiet room, with no TV on. Oh, people are going to watch this without seeing the chat window, so I should mention that Michael's album is at punkrockopera.bandcamp.com/releases. So when you're watching this on YouTube, hello Cocoa Butter 82, nice to see you here. Kid Scoop News on YouTube writes, do you prefer seeing your completed work online or in print? Well, I design it for print. And our paying customers are print customers. So, and I do still like the way drawings look on paper. Printed on nicely on paper. So I'll go with print. And also, I'm an old codger. People like to come onto Twitch and point out the old gray beard. So I think I would be expected to like print better. Cool Butter 82 writes, I have the same pencils, but I can't draw like you. Oh, well. Everybody's different. Hello, Brian and Deanna. Nice to see you here again. Time Waster. Cocoa Butter writes, I wish I saw you draw the hair. I really need to work on that. Well, lots of people just scritchy scratch hair, and what you need to do is really think your hair through, and as you're drawing it, think about how it feels and where the light source is, and how it falls in clumps rather than regular bits. In how it defines the volume of the form. And if you think about the hair thoroughly while you're drawing it, that's a big help. Drawing is really all about thinking of what you're drawing and feeling it in three dimensions. Unless you're a young web cartoonist who just draws stick figures. And I'm afraid that a lot of people can get away with just drawing the stick figures. Not as much respect for drawing as there used to be, I regret to say. I used to love the old Mad magazine. I used to love the comic books. I used to draw all the time and develop my skills. And kids now, they look at memes and kitties and they play video games. And the only comic book stuff they do is going to the movies. Funny, I'm the old gray-haired man on Twitch. Like I'm complaining at all the kids to get off my lawn. that's a kind of a design detail that goes like that. That I wouldn't have expected to put in had I not been looking at the photo scrap. Kit Scooper News writes, can you repeat the URL where the completed album cover will appear? I'm not sure where it'll appear. Michael gave a URL for... Here. Let's do that. It's punkrockopera.bandcamp.com/releases. punkrockopera.bandcamp.com/releases. You can listen to the music that looks just like what I'm drawing. Michael, see, the question came from YouTube, where they don't see what you're posting in the chat box on Twitch. Kid Scoop writes, thanks, looks so fantastic so far. Well, thank you for the kind words, Kid Scoop News. This logo is changing a bit from what it really looks like. I'm making it bigger and a little bit more descriptive of the volume. I think it needed that. Yes, Mac Cagle is my son who is being depicted on this album cover, and this is his punk rock opera that I'm drawing. And when I finish drawing this guy, I'm going to draw Michael's logo. This is Michael's logo, punk rock opera, but I'm going to draw it in my hand so it will look more interesting than this stinking just a font. And then we're gonna put it small down here in the corner. At least that's the plan. So all of you 10 people that are on Twitch, please, please, please subscribe, because I don't have enough people watching these things. Itchybrow12, thank you for the kind words. So Itchybrow, you're late to join us. This is I'm drawing punk rock CD cover. For my son the punk rocker. He really doesn't have quite this much hair, but he's close. The hair is not that much of an exaggeration. Oh, thank you for subscribing, Cocoa Butter. Next time I do a live stream, I should have the dancing taco going for when we get a new subscription. So one of the instructions from my art director son here is that the background should resolve to black so that he can print this on black t-shirts. I appreciate you, Cocoa Butter. Hello, Shuriland. Nice to see you here. We're picking up a few people on Twitch. It's nice. Shuriland, please subscribe. I'm hurting for subscribers. Coming up on pushing 3.5 hours working on this thing. I'm gonna finish this part pretty soon. Then the next thing I need to do is trace that draw over that logo. Thanks for the kind words, Kit Scoop News. Scoop News writes, do you ever get feedback or backlash from politicians or their subordinates? Typically, no, because if you consider what I'm doing, I'm drawing national issues, and the national debate is so big that I'm just not a significant voice. But when you draw local things, you hear back from politicians. It's fun to do local cartoons, and you can see much more what your impact is. But typically, the only time I hear from a politician on my national stuff, and it's rare, is when they want to get the original art to hang on their wall as a trophy. And one thing that's frustrating about that is that they don't care how you insulted them. The insult is just part of the trophy. And they tend to be pretty darn cheap. Starting to run out of pencils that have been sharpened. So folks, please do remember to follow me on Twitch, subscribe on Twitch. I do appreciate that. No more comments, folks? You've all gone silent. Been drawing this too long, huh? Actually, I don't think it's too unreasonable to spend 3 or 4 hours on a cartoon. Getting pretty close to finishing this. I think this is not going to be colored. It's just going to be line art. Marilyn Harmon writes, when you're done streaming, you might want to take a look at the TOS concerning streaming here and on other platform at the same time. They not want you to do that on Twitch? I know that when you're a partner, they want you to be exclusive on Twitch. But they have not endeavored to make me a partner. Thank you for the kind words, Heinz235. Writes, what's your favorite part of the figure to draw? Well, if you go to an art school and you look at figure drawing class, a favorite part of the to draw is always naked women breasts. Those kids come out of art school without being able to draw hands and feet, but they draw great breasts. I like the hands and feet. I'm gonna need a new piece of sandpaper. Kim G on YouTube writes, all my life I've had a love-hate relationship with pencils being left-handed. I see you are one as well. Small world, Kim G. Notice that I draw from right to left, and I'm not dragging my hand through the art like I would be if I was writing a letter. And I find at the end of it all, when I've got a nice pencil drawing on vellum here, pencil drawing looks nice. Notice that little bit of shine? A little bit of shine, it's nice. It doesn't look like that to me. I mean, you're getting a kind of an odd shiny view, but because of the lighting. But I like the textural aspect of it, looking at it and knowing that it's an original. You can get a sense of where the artist was moving his hand and thinking about something. And some of the ink drawings I see are so clean that you can't tell if they're copies. Not really a hint of where the artist was futzing around thinking. Kid Scoop News writes, which cartoonists were your earliest influence? My earliest influence was Fleischer Studios. I loved Popeye. I drew lots of Popeye when I was a tiny kid. I love the old Fleischer Studios stuff. I like the olive oil kind of elbows that are rounded. My son and I had a conversation about this, and I said, can I give you a round arm that doesn't have an elbow? And he says, I need an elbow. I want a sharp elbow. And I said, but you know, it's funny if your arm goes in a curve and it's not an elbow. I want an elbow, he says. Punk rockers have sharp elbows, he says. All right. But if it was up to me, be round. But I do take art direction. When it's not an editorial cartoon, I take art direction. All right, are we close to being done? I think I finished this in just about 3.5 hours. I have yet to scan it and clean up the stuff in the Photoshop, put in the little logo that's going to be down here in the corner. Somewhere I will reverse my signature out of it. Alright, well, I think that's kind of where it ends up. This is the art. Let's see if that helps. That's a little better. I like that without the light on it. Maybe I should have done that to start with. Turn off all the lights. Oh, that's too much. Anyway, here it is. Finished art. My son, the punk rocker. A few more lines to draw here. What else to futz with? I do get a different view when I'm looking in the monitor. Thank you for the kind words, Kid Scoop News. Do please remember to subscribe. If you'd run over to Twitch and subscribe, that would be nice. Alright, I think he's done. That is the end, folks. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to scan this and make it pretty as line art in Photoshop. Drop in that logo that I haven't quite drawn yet. And this will be finished. I'm not going to clean it up too much in Photoshop because he's a punk rocker, you know? It's supposed to be kind of grungy. Anyway, thank you, folks. Do please remember to subscribe. I appreciate your time sitting with me all afternoon here. And join me for the next one. I put out a notice on my Facebook page and Twitter when I'm going to do a new stream. So please come take a look. I'm continuing to futz with little details here. Anyway, thank you for your time and for watching, and I will see you with the next stream. Thank you so much, folks.